Welcome back, guys. We continue this Confederates campaign, and we're on to potentially the hardest mission in the game now, Hardin Pike. Now, it's hard because you take casualties. It's easy enough to actually win the mission. It's just at what cost? So, we're taking in all rookies because there's no point in risking the lives of the veterans, and all cannons. So, let's see how we get on. So I'm likely going to use time-lapse in this video because we're going to spend a lot of it just firing cannons.
Fire! Thank you.
So I've been looking at the numbers, and I've completed the mission a couple of times, and it's just simply not beneficial to go for the victory, I don't think. If you go for the victory, you basically get the enemy gets slightly worse weapons. So if you don't take the victory, they get slightly better weapons at Washington. But to get the victory, it costs you about an extra 8,000 manpower. So I'm thinking, for the sake of losing 8,000 manpower, I'd rather let the enemy have the better weapons. It just seems to make more sense to me. So we'll be able to get a draw with relatively minor casualties. So I'm pretty sure all you need is a contested timer. And then you can get a draw. So 4,000 losses. That's much better than, I mean, I was getting 17,000 losses going for the win. So I don't see the point in taking that type of losses just to get the enemy to have slightly worse guns. It means that it costs you a little bit of reputation. So it does cost a little bit, but we just got loads of men, like 12,000 men, so we actually got a net gain of 8,000 and 100 and something thousand cash, 120,000 I think it was. So we got a huge net gain there for the cost of a bit of reputation and the enemy having slightly better guns. Just seems to make sense to me. And then we've got to do the same thing again, basically, on the next mission anyway. What am I doing here? I'm not sure what on earth I'm doing here. I'm trying to find a gun. That's it. I don't know why I've taken him off there. That's what I was trying to do. So yeah, that's what we're doing. That's how we're playing it. So I'll probably do the same thing on the next mission as well. Let's have a look. So it costs us 14 reputation again. And we'll get 15,000 men and 123. And from that they get full morale. So, I mean, full morale is actually pretty bad, but it's full morale as bad as losing 8,000 men. I don't know, I'll have to have a think about it. But anyway, we'll call it a day for this one, guys. So cheers for watching, take care, and I'll see you soon.